We all use Google Drive, but are you managing the permissions of your folders and files properly to protect your data? If you spare 15 minutes after watching this video, you will become a master of managing permissions of your Google Drive. So let's get started after a short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. Google Drive is an online storage which we get free with all of our Gmail accounts. We get 15 GB of free cloud storage to save our important files. But managing permission of our files and folders is very important to protect our data. This video is a complete tutorial about Google Drive permissions and how you can manage these permissions. I will explain two important rules of file and folder permissions, and then I will show you on my Google Drive how to manage these permissions, how you can give access to someone to edit or organize your files, or even how you can transfer the ownership of your Google Drive folders to someone else. In some situations, you might seek the ownership of someone else's Google Drive, and we will see all this in this video. So now I will jump on my computer and I will show you how to manage Google Drive permissions. We share our files and folders with our friends and colleagues on a daily basis. In this video, I'm going to show you how Google Drive permissions work, what are different levels of permissions, and what happens when you assign permission to any folder or file. I will explain two important rules of assigning permissions, and then I will show you in my Google Drive how actually you can assign permissions to someone. So there are three levels of permissions in Google Drive. The first is the ownership, which is the highest level. Then and only the owner of the file has this permission, although you can transfer the ownership to some other person. It is possible, and I will show you why you need this and how can you do that. Then the second level of permission is edit permission, or organize and add and edit. So all kind of activities can be done if someone has this permission, except that person will not be the owner until you assign the ownership permission, of course. The third level of permission is the lowest level of permission, which is only view permission. Now, these two rules are common sense. And even if you don't know these rules, most of you will understand how permissions work. But before I show you how to assign permissions, I wanted to highlight these rules for someone who might not know this. So the first rule is called cascade rule. And this rule means that if you assign any of these permissions to a folder, the same permission will be transferred to all the files inside the folder. Or even if there is another folder, the same permission will be transferred to that folder as well. Let us assume that I assign organize permission to this folder, plus add and edit. In this case, that person will be able to organize all these files and also this folder and all the files inside the folder. So the same permission transfers from top to all the lower levels, level 1, level 2, all the levels. So this permission goes from top to bottom, you can say. And the second rule is override rule. So this cascade rule means that the permission transfers from top level to all the lower level files and folders. Now, override rule means that if the folder has a lower level of permission, let us say this folder has only view permission, but one of the files or folders inside this has a higher level of permission. For example, this file has organized permission. What this rule says is that if a file inside a folder has a higher level of permission, then this permission will prevail. This permission will prevail, and this permission will override this lower level permission at the top level. So that person will be able to organize this file meaning that he will be able to edit this file, he will be able to delete this file, move this file to somewhere else or to his or her own Google Drive. So all kind of things that person will be able to do. Even the folder has only view only permission. Now let's talk about the ownership permission. Why would you give someone ownership permission? And why you might seek ownership of certain files and folders? For example, I want to close one of my Gmail accounts. I have many accounts, but I want to keep my Google Drive folders. So what I can do is I can transfer the ownership of my Google Drive folders from my one Gmail account to another Gmail account. And in this way, I will be able to keep those folders. So this is the case when I want to transfer the ownership from one Gmail account to another Gmail account or to some friend, for example. But let us assume that you have given someone a contract to make your wedding videos. And when he makes the videos, he gives you a link to access those videos. Now, in that case, you might want him to transfer the ownership of that folder to you. Because why would he want? Because he should not keep the ownership of that folder. That is your videos, your folder. So in that case, you might ask him to transfer the ownership to you. Although he can still take a copy of that. But normally they don't do that. But you want that, you want to make sure that you have the ownership of that folder. Because if he at some stage accidentally changed the permission or he lost access to his drive or whatever my case might be. So in that case, you want the ownership of that folder. And I will show you how you can transfer the ownership and how he can transfer the ownership for you as well. So this was a brief introduction to these rules. And now I will show you how we can assign permissions to someone. What are different methods? So for someone who don't know how to get access to Google Drive, to get access to Google Drive, you have to open an account with Google. And just type Google support in your search console and you will get this page, or you can type this support.google.com on your browser, and this is the page support.google.com. This is a place where you open your Google account, and with every account you will get 15 GB of free online storage, which is called Google Drive. So here you, what you can do is you can normally use this icon, Google account, or you can just open a Gmail account. You can do either of these, and normally this is a preferred way. Just open a Gmail account and then you will get your Google Drive. And it's a very simple process. You just click on this Gmail and here you will have this option, create a Gmail account. You just click on that and then create an account, you click on that, and then enter your details and enter your preferred username. And when you click next, it will show you whether this name is available or not. If not, you can choose any other name until you get one. So this is the way you open your Google account. And once you have opened the Google account, then you can get access to Google Drive. And this is now my Google Drive. Just beside your icon, you will see these 9 dots. If you click on that, you will have this Drive icon. And if you click on that, you will get this page. So this is my Google Drive page. On the left-hand side, you can see this Drive symbol. On the left-hand side, you can see that this is my storage. You get 15 GB of free storage. I have used 2 GB. Now, let's see how I can assign permissions to my files or folders. As you can see that these are my folders, and some of these folders I have already shared. And this is how you can see whether you have shared a folder to someone or not. You will see this icon here. This folder is shared and this folder is not. It is just a folder symbol. But on these 3 folders, you will see a person's icon here. So it means that this folder has been shared to someone. And this is sometimes very important to know whether any folder has been shared or not. And if you click on this list view icon, and then you can also check if there is this sign, 2%, it means that this file has been shared to someone. This file has been shared to someone. This is a starred file, and this also has been shared to someone.
So this symbol is very important to look for, because you might have already shared some of your important data to someone, and then you can remove the access very easily by using the method which I am going to show you now. Let us go back to grid view. So let us assume I want to share this folder, my wedding video folder. So I click on that folder, and then I can click on this person's plus sign, or I can right click and I can click share. And when I click share, I will get this dialog box. Now there are two ways to share. If I know the email of that person, I can enter their email here. So I would enter one of my own email addresses. So I just click on this, and then I can add more email addresses if I want. And then I click on this, and now these are the two permissions. Now ownership permission is not showing here, and I will show you in a minute how we can transfer the ownership. But these two permissions I can assign here. This is the middle level permission, actually the high level permission after ownership, and this is the low level permission. So let us assume I want to share with all the organize and edit rights. So I click on this. I can add any note here to tell that person why I am sharing this file, and then I can click just send. And when I click send, I will see this message shared with one person, and that person will get an email saying that someone has shared a folder, and then that person can move that folder to their Google Drive or whatever they want, because I have given them organize access, full access. Now, the other method of sharing is, let's say I want to share this file. File or folder is same method. So I right click on that, I share. And now let us assume that I don't know the email address of that person. If I know, the method is same, I just enter the email, I click here, and then I can give access to edit. And because it's a file, so there is another access which is called can comment. So that person can comment in the file. So this is a little bit intermediate type of permission for files. And then can view. Can view means that person will only be able to view the file. But this method is same for the files and folders, except that this comment option is available for the files. But there is another option if I don't know the email address. So what I can do is I can just copy this link, and now the link is copied. This message will be there, link copied to clipboard. Then I can paste this link to somewhere, for example, on my website, and I can ask that person to get access to my file. Or if later I get the email address, I can send this link via email. And now, this is the access type. Anyone with the link can view. So this is only view access. If you want more high level access, you can click on that, and then you can select this one. Anyone with the link can edit or can comment, because it's a file. So these two access, you can click here. And if you click on this more options, there is one more option which is called public on the web. So if you select this option, it means that anyone on the internet can find the file and access the file. So it means that, as you can see, no sign in required. So this access is public, but this access is not public. This access is only if someone has the link. Now let's cancel this, and we want to give access to, let's say, view only, and then we can type my email, and then I can click send and shared with one person. And meanwhile, as you can see that now this icon appears on this folder. So it takes sometimes 1 or 2 minutes to appear here, because we recently shared this folder. Now this is how you can give access for edit, for view, or if it's a file, for comment. Now the last and important thing is how you can transfer the ownership of any folder. Now to transfer the ownership, what you do is, for example, I want to transfer the ownership of this folder. So the first step will always be to give the edit access. So I click on share, and now if I click on this advanced option, I can see that I have shared this file with this person and I am the owner. So once you have given someone edit access, and this is the level of access. If I click here, I can see that this is the level of access. I can change this level to view only, but here is the important part. I can change this level to owner as well. Once I have given the access to edit, then I can change that to ownership. So if I click on owner, and now I will get this message that you have made changes that you need to save. And if I click on save changes, it will give me this message. Are you sure? If you transfer ownership, the new owner will be notified. You may no longer be able to change sharing settings. Now, after this point, I will not be able to change the level of access, to remove access or anything else. And that person can kick me out of this folder forever, because now that person is the owner. And if I click yes, and then I click done, now the ownership of this has been transferred. And now if I click on this file, I still have this share option. And if I click on share option and I click on advanced, so this is my email for this Google Drive. And if I click here, I still have this access, organize access. It means I can share this file to anyone. But now, because this person is the owner, so this person can remove this access from his own Google Drive. So he has to log in to his Google Drive and then remove this access for this email. So this is how ownership can be transferred. And when we share our Google Drive files to someone, that person gets these kind of emails. So we shared this Google Docs file and we transferred the ownership of this folder. So this is the email invitation to view. And if I click on this email, it's a generic email sent by Google that this person has invited you to view the following document. And similarly, when I transfer the ownership, the other person will get this email, transfer of ownership. And this email will say something like this, that this person has made you the owner of the following shared folder. So this is how the ownership transfer is completed. So that is all about Google Drive permissions. Now the last thing is, I have shown you how to check which folders and files you have shared by looking at this sign, and for files going into list view and looking for this sign. But what other persons have shared to you, you can check by clicking on this shared with me. So this folder is always available in Google Drive. If I click on that, I will see that this one folder has been shared with me. That is all about Google Drive permissions, how to give someone permission, how to change the permission, and how to see what folders have been shared, what files have been shared by you or with you.
So I hope you like this video and you will be able to manage permissions and protect your data. Thanks for watching and see you next time.